achieved its aim. But now, as it faces the post-Iran deal reality, we have an administration that seems to be signaling that the peace process is dead, to all intents and purposes. In fact, when President Rivlin came out of his meeting with President Obama, and he was talking to Israeli journalists, it was a very surreal situation where he was telling Israeli journalists that President Obama kept on telling him how hopeless the situation is, how nothing's going to happen, and he, Rivlin, of all people, was trying to encourage him and to tell him, well, you have to think of new solutions and maybe interim steps, and so perhaps now, and my question is, I'm connecting that to this issue, perhaps now if the peace process is dead, perhaps at least in terms of Israel, the Jewish community doesn't have what to fight about anymore. Never mind that Jay Street has to think what it's going to do next.
Well, I'd love to hear about sort of the, where the president is, on this right now. But if the peace process is moving at the moment, that doesn't mean that the aspiration of two-state solution, but the importance of American leadership around this issue and the importance of shifting the political dynamics in this country in order to move what's happening over there isn't crucial and critical and happening. So I don't, if at any moment there is a pause in a process, if it isn't moving forward, we still have to do the work on the ground to make sure that this country is moving on the right path in terms of where Israel, it's how it supports Israel and how it defines what pro-Israel means. That means that right now we're making sure that issues like the Green Line are in the consciousness of the American Jewish community and in the consciousness of legislators, and that there is a clear distinction when we talk about Israel between Israel and the territory it occupies. It means that we continue to engage members of Congress around the importance of America being engaged on this issue. It's just because something isn't moving forward at a particular moment doesn't mean that the work at hand isn't critical and isn't going to move forward, and it is moving forward.
Matt.
I guess I would take issue with the notion that we've given up on a two-state solution or advancing the peace process. I mean, you heard the president address this conference today. Look, we were pleased to work to make that happen. I do want to thank Haaretz for being an important partner in supporting two-state solutions. Very important, and that's, we're happy to be here today. But there's the near-term reality that there aren't direct negotiations taking place now. But at the same time, we are actively working on thinking about confidence-building measures that both sides can take. Secretary Kerry recently traveled to Jerusalem and Ramallah. There will certainly be a lot of activity going forward to find ways to move the process ahead, even if in the immediate term, this two-state solution seems remote. So we believe in the urgency of addressing this conflict and finding a way to achieve a two-state solution. We've said it time and again in many different ways, and that hasn't
changed. Why was Rivlin so, who gave him that impression?
Well, you heard what the president said here. I think, it's a question of what we think is can be accomplished in the near term versus, somewhat longer horizon. Rob Malley, who's going to speak at the conference today, can address that further, I'm sure he will. And I just want to also make one comment, about the organized Jewish community. I don't quite see it in such a, binary way. I don't think that, progressives should write themselves out of the organized Jewish community because, J Street is an important part of the organized Jewish community, and it, along with many folks in the organized community, whether it's Greg Rosenbaum at NJDC or many former leaders of major Jewish organizations, came together, and that organizing that took place in support of the Iran deal was absolutely essential in achieving the objective, even whereas some of the other more long-standing organizations might have been against it. But then look at an issue like the refugee issue, which we were talking about, and it's, that to me represents the Jewish community at its best, because we're drawing on our own tradition, our own history, our own appreciation of that our parents, grandparents, refugees in this country to come together, you know, and support addressing the solution in a way that is both true to American values and Jewish values, but also protects our security.